it's moving. And it's going to do that in the background, so the app's still responsive. Watch this. The boxes in the right are differentials. How crazy is that? Did you ever think you'd see background processing? You'd see video motion detection done in JavaScript in the browser? You know, I certainly didn't. This is just fantastic and a great demonstration of these capabilities all coming together and the kind of rich app that we can now start to build within the browser. So hope you like that. Let's go back to slides. Very good. And once again, that capability broadly available in these modern browsers. So I hope you've enjoyed that section of the talk. That was about a more powerful web and how, as an industry, we are creating new capabilities, but it's still up to us as a community to build the applications that take advantage of that more powerful web. I'm going to pivot at this point and now talk about making it easier to build those kind of apps and how Google services can help you. Obviously, if you came to last year's developer conference or attended any of our Google Campfire ones or watched them online, you know that Google's deeply interested in making it easier for you to build web apps. Two of our offerings in this space have been Google App Engine and Google Web Toolkit. Google App Engine's value proposition was very simple. We said, let us provide the hosting for your app. So you don't have to worry about machine instances. You don't have to worry about the app scaling. You don't have to carry a pager. We'll do that for you. And we're going to give you an update on that in a moment. Google Web Toolkit had a different proposition. It said, write in Java, and we'll compile down, understand which browser is being used, and push down the appropriate JavaScript, and do it in a fantastic way that allows you to target multiple browsers. To give you an update on Google App Engine and Google Web Toolkit, let me invite up Andrew Bowers and Kevin Gibbs. Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Vic. You know, the interest in adoption that we've seen in Google App Engine over the past year has been truly remarkable. We've had over 200,000 developers sign up to use Google App Engine, and not a single one of those developers had to purchase or provision a server to get started. They were able to develop their application locally on their own machine, be it Mac, Windows, or Linux, and leave the servers to us. Now, our SDK is just 3 megabytes. If you haven't tried out App Engine before, I encourage you to download it. Give it a shot. Now, since we launched App Engine last year, we've also had over 80,000 applications deployed on Google App Engine. Now, often these applications have been created by small and agile teams, like many of you in the audience here, and they can be, because with App Engine, you don't have to worry about your configuration, your uptime, or usage spikes, or re-architecting your application once it finally starts to get popular. In fact, we were able to put this policy to the test ourselves when the White House decided to use Google Moderator, which runs on Google App Engine, for President Obama's live town hall event. Despite a traffic peak of 700 requests per second and promotions on all the major search engines and news sites, the application scaled to meet the traffic, and none of the other applications were affected. Now, over the past year, we've also launched a number of features and improvements to App Engine, including things like our SSL support, Memcache API, the system status site, access to secure data behind the firewall, and the ability to pay for usage beyond our free quotas. Now, we've also found that there's a number of additional things that we'll launch to you in the coming months. They include things like background processing for your jobs and large object support for your application. If you'd like to learn more, I'd urge you to come to our sessions here at Google I/O over the next 2 days. Now, certainly the feature that we've launched recently that's generated the most noise and the most buzz is our Java language support. The interest in our Java support since we launched it a month and a half ago has been remarkable. In a matter of days, even hours since we launched our Java support, we saw developers, many of you in the audience here today, dive in and get not only Java frameworks working on App Engine, but also other JVM languages, including things like JRuby, Groovy, Scala, and even PHP. And that, we thought, was truly amazing. I'd like to say thank you for all of you early adopters who gave this a try and gave us some feedback with the system. Now, we found that the demand for Java on App Engine has been so overwhelming and the response so positive, we think that we're ready to take the next step with Java on App Engine. So I'd like to announce, sorry, I'd skip the slide. I'd like to announce that we are opening signups for Java on App Engine as of right now. Anyone can now log in and create a Java application immediately. Thank you. Now with that, I'd like to stop telling you about our Java support and App Engine and start showing you. So I'd like to pull over Andrew Bowers. Andrew is going to demonstrate to you how we have an end-to-end solution for creating Java applications using Google Web Toolkit and Google App Engine. Andrew's going to demonstrate to you how we think we have a way to make applications both more scalable and easier to use, with backends running on Google App Engine and frontends built with Google Web Toolkit. Andrew?
Thanks, Kevin. So if any of you have ever done Java development, you've probably experienced the frustrating lag between getting a development environment set up and actually deploying something to the web. And if you're working on a weekend project, maybe you decided to go ahead and use something like Ruby on Rails because you wanted to actually get something out there. So we definitely recognize that pain and frustration in our own lives and tried to make the on-ramp to a new app as quick as possible. So to demonstrate, I'm going to create the starter project from the Eclipse plugin. I'm going to deploy that to the web. And I'm going to use Google Web Toolkit and App Engine, and hopefully it should take me about 2.5 minutes. So somewhere around there is my goal. So here I have the Eclipse development environment, and let's just get started. I'm going to go ahead and open up the new project wizard. I'll create something called com.google, create a package. And I'm going to use Google Web Toolkit and App Engine. And this is going to create the starter project for me. Oh, looks like we already had something running. We'll go ahead and stop that. And now I'm going to start that on a local server. So this is has everything I need already. I didn't have to install Tomcat. All I did was I installed the Google plugin for Eclipse into my Eclipse development environment. That downloaded the App Engine SDK, the Google Web Toolkit SDK, and the local development server, which mimics the production environment. So now I have a very simple AJAX application. It takes some text here, asynchronously sends that to the server, echoes the text back, as you can see, and then gives me a little information about the server that I'm running, just so we can tell that it's actually going to the server. So if we look at the code for that, open up the project here, you can see I have a client package and a server package. Now, all of the code inside my client package is Google Web Toolkit code that's Java code that's going to be compiled into JavaScript in the final step. And it's using widgets and it's using events, so they're abstracted away so that it'll work across browsers. So I could change the text on the button here to post. Inside my server package, I have Java classes that are going to run as bytecode on the server. And you can see that I'm getting an RPC, and I'm echoing it back. So we'll say hello from Google I/O. We'll save that there. Now if I go back, so I've just edited Java code. I'm going to go back to my browser. I'll click refresh. And I see it says post, and I see it says hello from Google I/O. So I just edited Java, but I'm seeing those changes now in my browser. OK, so I've got a small functioning app. Let's go ahead and deploy that out to the web. Go back into Eclipse. I'll go up to the deploy wizard. And you'll notice there's an error here right now. That's because I haven't set an application ID. So I'm going to go to the App Engine console, and I'll create a new application ID. We'll say demo for I/O, and we'll save that, and hope no one beat me to it out there. OK, you're not fast enough. Great, so we'll go back. I had some backups just in case. So we'll set the application ID here in the environment. And all I need to do now is enter in my username and password, then hit the deploy button. The SDK is taking care of the rest for me. So it's going to convert that Java code from Google Web Toolkit in the client package to JavaScript. It's going to compile the Java code to bytecode for the server-side stuff, package all that up into a web archive directory, and deploy it to the server. There's no FTP involved by me, no server configuration. Everything's handled within the SDK. And I could do this from the command line if I wanted to as well. And so now we should have a deployed app, and hopefully within a few minutes here. So let's go to that demo for io.appspot. And so I've got a fully functioning, if not very functional, app out on the web.